The Immigration Department mapping out new strategies to generate more revenue for this country. The department is launching its extended stay permit in the coming days. Here's Keisha Adderley.
This program will allow international students and workers to reside in the Bahamas for 12 months. Successful applicants will study and work remotely while enjoying the pleasures of the Bahamian experience. The government has prioritized the extended stay permit program as a revenue-generating activity recommended by the Economic Recovery Committee.
The permits will go for $500 per student and $1,200 for working individuals under these terms further explained by the immigration director.
Students and remote professionals to reside in the Bahamas for 12 months, period of 12 months. Program will allow successful applicants to study and work remotely while enjoying the pleasures of the Bahamian experience. They will work outside of the Bahamas, meaning you can work remotely in the Bahamas while enjoying the Bahamian experience, but your work must not interfere with the workforce of the Commonwealth of the Bahamas.
Meantime, the Ministry of Trade and Industry continues to chip away at the World Trade Organization accession process, now into its 19th year. The country's agenda seeks to increase awareness over trade opportunities, especially in these uncertain times, all while shoring up intellectual property rights.
The unit is currently working along with the Office of the Attorney General and the Law Reform Commission to review existing intellectual property and competition policies. Of course, on the horizon, we have the nation's eventual accession to the World Trade Organization, which will bring even more trade opportunities for local business and business owners. Trade and industry-related policy will play a significant role in our economic recovery. We are living in the era of globalization and service to customers abroad. My ministry has overseen the development of a three-step plan to move the economy forward through strengthening the national approach to trade.
Familiarization with trade deals, information on trade agreements, and information on access and facilitating concession opportunities for business persons are among the priorities. Nearly $230,000, meantime, in concessions since July have helped manufacturers get to the next level, and there's a move to increase the efficiency of that unit.
My ministry is improving access to applicants under the Industries Encouragement Act and improving the speed of processing requests. The Industries Encouragement Act provides duty-free concessions for the importation of machinery, raw material, and building supplies for locally based manufacturers, as well as exemptions for real property tax. Local manufacturers will enjoy a faster process that gives quicker access to related tax relief and concession.
Keisha Adderley, ZNS Network News.